Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. So I think by now everyone agrees that the big thing they really want out of LLMs is the ability to do reasoning and to be able to solve problems with logic like humans do, and to do this for problems that they haven't seen in their training set. I want to follow this with some interesting developments and challenges that happened on Twitter over the last few days. So Victor Talin posted this reasoning challenge for LLMs a few days ago on Twitter. And he claims that this is a simple puzzle that GPTs will never solve. And it's actually pretty simple. So this is the description of the problem. You can see that this is basically about rewriting rules. He defines four tokens in his language. And then there are a bunch of rewriting rules to change tokens to other tokens or to consume tokens altogether. And you start with a given sequence of tokens. You keep applying these rules until you can't apply them anymore. And at that point, you get your final answer. So this is a pretty simple rule-based rewriting task. And he claims that current LLMs that follow the transformer architecture will not be able to solve this problem. And then a day or two after that initial tweet, he put his money where his mouth was and put up $10,000 as a challenge to prove him wrong. The challenge was to solve a 12-token instance of this AB problem with a 90% success rate. And he has some constraints about the way the answer should be formatted and how many tokens you're allowed to use. Any prompting technique is allowed, but it must be a GPT. It must be based on the transformer architecture, because he's trying to say that transformers aren't capable of this kind of reasoning. And of course, the internet never ever fails to take up a challenge. Less than 24 hours after this challenge was posted, the $10,000 was claimed. And Victor described in a long tweet all the attempts and what happened to finally claim the prize. So you can read the entire tweet. I'll link this entire set of tweets in the description. But it looks like initial attempts only hit about a 10% success rate, but then some folks submitted a prompt based on Claude 3 Opus, achieving a 56% success rate. And finally, the winning entry was from Twitter user Futuristic Frog, which got about a 94% success rate. So the challenge was to achieve more than 90%, so this wins the challenge. Unfortunately, the prompt that the winning strategy used is not public yet, but it will be made public later this week. So I'm really excited to see what that prompt looks like, and I'll probably follow up this video with a look at what that winning prompt was. So this goes to show that yes, LLMs can do reasoning, but you might have to do a lot of work on your prompt before you get them to solve a specific class of problem. Also, I thought that the author's original claim was a bit too strong. So we know that LLMs can do reasoning because we've run benchmarks like Big Bench Hard on these LLMs and a bunch of other benchmarks that test reasoning problems. So if you look at Big Bench Hard, which has all sorts of logical deduction problems and puzzles, Claude 3 gets about 87% on that benchmark. If you want to see the benchmark itself in a bit more detail, I made a video a couple of weeks ago about the benchmarks themselves. But you can see here that Opus gets about 87%, even Sonnet gets about 83% on this benchmark. The question is, there hasn't been any work, at least that I'm aware of, that neatly draws a boundary around what kinds of reasoning LLMs can do and what kinds they can't do. So they can do reasoning, but they seem to have a much tougher time with some kinds of reasoning than with others. Now, is it just the kinds of reasonings that they have or haven't seen in their training set that they do or don't have a hard time with? We don't know. Maybe there needs to be some formal study of what the architecture itself is capable of. Things like problem classes, like you have P and NP and so on. The other interesting thing out of this whole saga on Twitter was that it seems like Claude Opus now is the hottest LLM. Most of the attempts that came close, and of course the winning attempt itself, were based on Claude Opus rather than GPT-4. So that's an interesting development because GPT-4 was the reigning champion for a very long time. So I'm going to wait until Wednesday to see what the winning prompt was and hopefully follow up with a video on that prompt. I hope you enjoyed that. And if you like content like this, please like the video, consider subscribing, and I will see you all next time. Thank you very much.